Hello everybody.
Today we are going to see some examples which are depend on the frequency polygon. Already we have seen some examples. Once again, we are going to see some examples for the practice. Okay. So today's first example is the polygon table gives the distribution of IQs, that is intelligent quotients, of 60 pupils of class 9 in a school. Okay. And this data is given in the table. So IQ and number of people. These are the intervals. Okay, intervals are given and number of people are given 1, 3, 6, 8, 10, 8, 5, 3, 2, and 1. And instruction is given: construct a frequency polygon for awarded about data. Okay. So here we need to prepare frequency polygon. Getting everybody. So now as we know that we need class mark. Number of people is given. Okay, so from class mark we will take from this. Okay, that is IQ. The intervals are given. From intervals we can find out class mark and number of people are given. So this will be y coordinate, and the mean of this, that is class mark, is the x coordinate. Okay, so these two points we will get. Then that is those two points we can put on the graph. Okay, so first we need to find out class mark of this all intervals. Okay. Okay, see here. So here first interval is 125.5 and 132.5. Okay, so if I want to find out class mark, then what I will do here? I need to addition of lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. Okay, so the same formula we will use for all the intervals, then we will get automatically class mark. Okay, so our first is 125.5 plus 132.5. Okay, so all the points I will take here. So 125.5 plus 132.5, what is the addition of these two? Addition will come 258. Okay, the sum of this, here also you can do direct sum of these two is 258. So 258 divided by 2 will be 12 and 9, 129. So our point is 129 and this is 1. Okay, so our first plotting point is 129, comma 1. Okay, so this is x coordinate and this is y coordinate. Okay, so like that we will put on the graph. Second is 180 plus 125.5. The sum of this, sum of these two will be 244. Okay, so 244 divided by 2. Understood? Because we are finding class mark, so it will be 120. So our second plotting point is 122 and 3. Okay. Now after this, we will see the sum of these two: 111.5 plus 118.5. Okay. So this sum is 130. The sum of this will come 130. Okay, so 230. Sum of these two will be 230 divided by 2. So 230 divided by 2, that is 215. Okay, so our third crossing point is 115 is frequency, that is number of people are given, that is 6. Okay, so now next one, 104.5 plus 111.5. Okay, so it will be sum of this is 216 divided by 2. So that will be 108. So our next point is 108 and this is 108. Okay. After that, 97.5 plus 104.5. Okay, so 97.5 plus 104.5. The sum will be 202. 202 divided by 2. 202 divided by 2. So 202 divided by 2 will be 101. So our next plotting point is 101, 10. Okay. Next is 90.5 and 97.5. We need to do addition of this is 90 plus 90.5 plus 97.5. So sum of this is it will become 188 divided by 2. Okay, so 188 divided by 2, that will be 94. So next plotting point is 94, 8. Okay, so now next one is 83.5 plus 90.5. Understood? So this addition will come. This addition will come 174 divided by 2. So it will be 2 8s are 16. 2 7s are 14. Okay, so it will be 87. So next plotting point is 87 comma 5. Okay, after this point will come this is 76.5 plus 83.5. So it will be 160 divided by 2 will be 2 8s are 80. So next plotting point is 80 and 3. Okay, then next one is 69. Second loss is 69.5 plus 76.5. Sum of these two will be 146. Divided by 2. 2 7s are 14. 2 3s are 6. So 73, 2. Okay, and last one point is 62.5 plus 69.5. So that sum 62.5 plus 69.5 will be 132. 132 divided by 2. So 2 6 are 66. So last point is 66, and its frequency is 1. Okay, so these are all of the plotting points. Okay, these points we need to show on the graph. Okay, so again now we need to think about the scale. Okay, so here we can, if you want, you can put in the form of tables. So here the same table is going to come. Now we need to think about the x axis first and then y axis. Okay, so we will see the target. See, x coordinates are the x coordinate. According to this, we need to spread the scale. Okay, so here this is x coordinate. So on x axis, minimum is 66. Okay, minimum is 66 and maximum number is 129. Understood? So this is the greatest term, and this is minimum is 66. Okay, so according to this we will, okay, see here, now we are going to put this on the graph. Okay, so just now we have discussed that is smallest reading is 66 and largest is 120. So here we have taken 65 70 75 80 85 90, like that till the we have taken 130 and 140. Okay, so now here kink is necessary or zigzag line is necessary, because directly from 0 to 65 we have taken. Afterwards, the difference is same. 65 plus 5 is 70, 70 plus 5 is 90. Difference is same, but here from 0 to directly 65 we have taken, and that is not necessary. Okay, so here with the help of zigzag line, that is we can show this way to take directions. Okay, so now we need to think about the y axis. On y axis, readings are greatest is same and smallest is 1. Smallest is 1. Okay, so greatest is same. So we have enough place, so we can take here this is 1, then 2, then here 3, under that we have taken 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, and 14. Not necessary, only 10 is enough. Okay, so now first one is 129, one anyhow we can represent, because points are going to come on the same location. So 129 and 1. Okay, so 129 will come here, 120 125 130. Okay, it will be exactly in graph, on the graph paper exactly will be the location. Here I am taking little less 129 and 1. So that will intersect 129 and 1 between this point is 129 and 1. The next one is, this is done 122 and 122 and 3. 122, it will be 120 and 122 and 3. 3, this is both the, it will intersect here. So 122 and, okay, this is our next point. Then 120, this is done. Then 115 and 6. 115, you will get here, and 6. 6 is here. Okay. So both will intersect here. Okay. Then next point is 108 and 8. Okay. 108 will be here, and we need to take 8. Okay. So that point will be here. Okay. So here, if you want, you can write here 108 and 108 and 8. Okay. So first point, whatever we have written, 129, 1. Then 122, 3. 122, 3. Then we have taken 115 and 6. 115, 6. Okay. Then 108 and 8. Then 101 and 8. 101. You see this 100 is here. 101. And this is coming here. And 8. So this point will come. 101 and 8. Okay. Then next 94 and 8. 94 is here. And 94 and 8. It will come here. Okay. So this is little bit 94 and 8. Okay. Then 87 and 5. 85, 80, 90 here. 85 and 90. Understood. So exactly it will be 87.5. This midpoint is 87.5. Okay. So we need 87 only. Okay, so little bit here we will take, and this is reading is 5. 5 is, it is going to go 87 and 5. Okay. Next one is 83. 80 and 3. This is little bit very easy. 83. Okay. Next 73, 2. 75, 70. Here it will come 72.5. 73 we need here. And y coordinate is 2. So it will come here. 72, 73, 4, and 2. Okay. Then 66. 66 and 1. 66 and 1. It will be here. 66 and 1. Okay. So this will be your when we will join this with the help of scale. Okay. So that time our frequency polygon is. So, with the help of scale, we need to join it. Okay. So now we need to take starting point and end point. Okay, 65 and 66 equals. Okay, so before that, the will be this. So we can join this to the origin. That is so zero frequency. So it can come like this. Okay. And next one is 135 and 140. This is will come here. So next point we need to write in the last zero frequency. Okay. So that can come after 135. So we can join this. Okay. So now here your frequency polygon is ready. Okay. Got it, everyone? So this way you need to prepare frequency polygon for the given information. Here it is not necessary. Classes are discontinuous here. Okay, classes are discontinuous. So no problem, because we need class mark. So we need average of these intervals. So class mark is necessary. So not necessary to do classes continuous. When classes need to be continuous? When for histogram, suppose we want to construct a frequency polygon, that then classes should be continuous. Histogram is what? Continuous frequency polygon. Okay. Okay, see here our next problem. This problem we have taken from the NCERT textbook. Okay. So what is the problem? problem C. The following two tables gives the distribution of students of two sections according to the marks obtained by them. Okay, this is given information and we have to construct here, represent the marks of the students of both the sections on the same graph by two frequency polynomials. Okay, here we have to use two frequency polynomials. At the same time, frequency polynomials on the same graph. Okay, same graph. We need to show here two types of information: section A and section B. Okay. So now see here, what is given? Section A marks are given 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, and frequency is given 3, 9, 17, 12, 9. Okay. In section B, if you will observe here, see marks are 0 to 10. 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50. These intervals in both the section, intervals are same. Okay. So definitely its class mark is going to come same. Understood? So here I have taken a common class mark section for both the classes. Okay. So here first marks are going to come as equal 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, and 40 to 50. Okay. Common class mark. That is, the intervals are same for both the sections. Okay. So now class mark is going to become 0 plus 10 is 10 divided by 2 is 5. 10 plus 20, 30 by 2 is equal to 15. 20 plus 30, 25 by 2 is 25. 30 plus 40, 70 by 2 is 35. 40 plus 50 is 90 by 2 is 45. Okay. Section A frequency will be as it is 3, 9, 17. That is here 3, 9, 17, 12, and 9. Then next frequency, section B 5, 19, 15, 10, and 1. Okay, this is the required frequency. That is given. Okay. Only what we have done, class mark would be common because section intervals are same. So class mark we have taken common. Now this is very easy to show. Okay. Two types of lines we will show. For this we can use section A, we can use dotted line, and for this we will use continuous line. Okay. So here our first point will be 5, 3, 15, 9 for section A, 25, 17, 35, 12, 45, 9. For section B we will use 5, 5, 15, 19, 25, 15, 35, 10, 45, 1. Okay. So only the thing is that we need to think about the whole data, okay, to spread the scale. Okay, so here see, class mark we are going to show on the x-axis. So minimum is 5 and maximum is 45. Minimum is here 5 and maximum is 45. Understood? So here what we can do? Here we can take 45 is the highest. So maximum we can take 50, 60. 60 is required. Understood? 60 is required, or 55 also is enough. Understood. So that we are going to. Okay, see here. So we need to plot this information on the graph. Okay. Now maximum is 45. Okay. So here suppose we will take 0. This is origin. So this I am taking here 5. Okay. Then here it will be 10. Then 50, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40. 45, 45, then 50, and 55, okay, 60, okay, 5, 10, 50, 20, 25, okay, like that we have taken. Now see, this we need to think about section A, frequency, 3, this is, lowest is 1, and highest is 90, lowest is 1, highest is 90, so this we are going to show on the y-axis, so here we can take like this also, this is 1, okay, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Okay, so here now we have taken the scale according to the both the sections and class mark. Okay, so now our first point is, first we will show about section A.
Okay, so 5B, section A. For section A, we will use dotted line. Afterwards, we will see. First, we will plot this 5, 3. So 5 is here and 3 is here. Okay, so this is 5, 3. The next one is 15, 9. 15 and 9. 15 and 9 is here, so it will come. This point will come here. 15 and 9. Then after that 25, 17. 25 is here and 17. 25 will be and 17 is here. Okay, so 25, 17. Then 35, 12. 35 is here and 12 is 35 and 12. So it will come here. 35 and 12. Okay. Then 45, 9. 45 and 9. 45 and 9 is that point will be intersect 45, 9. Okay. So all these points are over. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 5 points are there. So here we can use dotted line for section A. Understood? So dotted line we have taken here. With the help of dotted line we can show this. Okay. Now the thing is that initial and starting point. Okay. We need to this is frequency 5. So before that frequency will be definitely 0. Okay. So this we can take here. And here jack line will not come because these are continuous 0 to 5, 5 to 10. Okay. We have started from origin only 0 to 5, 5 to 10. Okay. So jack line will not come here. This is also here 45. 45 is even. So it can come in the next interval whose frequency is 0. So this we can join after 45. Okay, so frequency is 0. Understood? Now after this we need to use, here we can write for section A. Section A dotted line we have given. Okay, now section B continuous line we will use. Section B continuous like that we use. Okay, so now section B, this is the common point 5, 5. Okay, so this is 5 and the 5 point is here. Okay, so this is 5, 5. Next is 15, 19. 15 is here and 19 is the 15 and 19. Okay, then 25, 15. 25 and 15 will come. 15 is here. 25 and 15. Okay. Then 35, 10. 35 and 10 is here. 35 will be. It will intersect here. 35, 10. Okay. And 45, 1. 45 and 1. 45, 1. Okay. So now. This we will join with the straight line. Understood? So this I am taking here. Straight line. Okay. First one is 5, 5. This is over. Then 15, 19. Then 25, 15. 25, 15 is here. Okay. Then 35, 10. 35, 10 is here. And then it will be 45, 45, 1. So we can join this after that whose frequency is 0. So now here we have shown both the section A and section B on the same graph with different types of lines. Okay, so this way we can show both information or more than one information on the same graph. Okay, which things are common that you have seen. So do this in your notebook. Okay, and solve such type of another problems from the worksheet and the NCERT exercise. Thank you very much.